For more on European banks now, we're joined by Michael Mackey, is Kingdon Capital Management Chief Investment Officer. Kingdon has $1.4 billion in assets under management. Some of those assets are in European banks, as we understand it, although not in Deutsche Bank, right?
No, we're not shareholders of Deutsche Bank. And you know, speaking with regards to what was just talked about, I do believe that Commerzbank is an interesting target for other companies as well. And there's a potential that that's what's really accelerating this now versus 2 years ago as well, is that, you know, there has been talks potentially of other suitors looking at Commerzbank. If we ever were to get to a European deposit scheme that guaranteed deposits, it's a very rich deposit base. And if, you know, if deposits were fungible around the Eurozone, very attractive target for somebody else to use.
And of course, you've been looking at Italy, including the banks there. You don't hold Deutsche Bank right now, as we mentioned. What would prompt you to consider taking a stake? Is there anything that you'd want to see on the horizon that would make you say, oh, this is a good opportunistic moment?
I mean, I think the point made earlier about the Sparkassen, which is the retail banking system there, and the Landesbanken, which is more the commercial banking system there, have such low ROEs that it makes it very tough because there's very little profitability. Deutsche Bank has a 3% ROE, so it's not really earning its cost of capital, hence why it trades at its price to book that it does. Mm-hmm. It does trade at 9.5 times earnings, though. So you'd really need to see a major restructuring, probably continuation of what you've already started to see on the investment banking side, which we're seeing in the United States a bit from them, and possibly a merger. I think they're okay on capital. I think they're fine on liquidity. They're actually have one of the higher liquidity coverage ratios out there. So I don't look at Deutsche as a systemic risk. I just don't look at it as a compelling of an investment right now. But potentially, if they could maybe bring in some Cerberus people, combined, we've got a 5% stake, as you said, in one in Commerce and 3% in the other. Obviously, the one factor that I do think is out there, the German government obviously still has a large stake in Commerzbank at a much higher level. And so it's going to have to be interesting where, you know, what paper they want to take. Yeah. And to your point earlier, possibly Deutsche Bank paper is better than taking from another country.
Now, as you pointed out, Deutsche Bank is trading at a discount. In fact, as you pointed out in advance of your visit to us, European banks in general are trading at a discount. We made a chart of it looking at the price to tangible book. And this looks at the BKX as well as the S&P bank, the European banks, Eurostoxx banks index, excuse me. And you see the gap there in valuation. But as you said with Deutsche Bank, it's cheap for a reason.
Correct.
And so where else are you seeing things that maybe are cheap, but some of the attractiveness is being overlooked?
And so Italy has obviously been in the forefront. And, you know, as you guys mentioned earlier, we definitely have some positions in Italy. I think it's very volatile. I think you have to be very patient on your entry points. Uncertainty in Italy is not anything new. They've had, I believe, 66 governments in the past 72 and a half years. So turning over to this government, you know, while there is a tremendous amount of uncertainty, and I don't doubt that the market may very well test the resolve of the ECB. And the one difference here I see when people try to compare this to Greece is that most of the Greek debt was held outside of the country. It was held either by the banks or by other institutions. In Italy, 65% of debt is held by Italians. And so as debt spreads widen out, you can't say to some of the big, larger institutions, you know, who cares about them? This is going to be your actual saver who's sitting in Italy, waking up the next day or week later saying, how did my savings just go down 10%?
Does that make them safer investments or less safe investments as a result?
I think it potentially, you know, because you've obviously got polling and the Northern League obviously has improved since we've had the election in March, and it's now about 29% versus five-star at 30. I think there's still people that are, you know, there's still a wallet issue that's there where people do vote with their wallet. And I think, you know, if you watch the polling, you'll continue to see if this continues to happen, Five Star and Northern League start to lose some of their popularity as people start to see their wallet diminish.
Got it. All right. Lots of implications there. Michael Mackey, Chief Investment Officer of Kingdon Capital Management. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.